with Lou doing what he's got to do, I figured I'd stop out of the shop for a few minutes and go to Amelia Island, because you know what? It's a Camaro day. And right now, they're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Camaro, and behind me is the one that started it all. It's been discovered. It's been found. Camaro number one. That's what you get to look forward to after the break.
This segment of Car Fix is brought to you by Grundy Worldwide, insuring collector cars since 1947.
Welcome to Amelia Island, where it's a very special year for the Camaro because it's its 50th anniversary, and they're proudly being honored right here among all these amazing cars. But before we get too carried away showing you everything Amelia Island has to offer, let's go get Jim Grundy involved. He's a great tour guide. If you ever find yourself at a concourse event, you have to go find Jim Grundy from Grundy Insurance. He knows all the right people to talk to and the perfect cars to see. Our first stop with Jim is where else? Original Camaro prototype number one, to meet the amazing young man, Logan, who discovered the car and found out all of the history behind it.
And the VIN number is?
Yeah, it's N100001. It's riveted in on the 8-pillar. I mean, you just take it as gospel until you figure the history.
And when you found the car, where was it?
It was in Oklahoma.
So you said to your dad, let's go for a ride. I got an old car I want you to look at.
Yeah, actually, I was like, hey, I have school tomorrow, but can you go look at the car? And he was like, yeah, I'll just drive down and look at it.
Logan has compiled a database for 10 of these pilot prototype cars. They were all part of the original 52 Camaro prototypes, none of which I knew about until I met Logan.
Because there wasn't any history on it, and GM didn't have any paperwork, so all we had was a VIN number to go off of. So we started with, from us, going through all the owners and tracking down every single piece of history that we could throughout the whole life of the car, and find the people that built it, and then also finding of the lost documentation that the workaholics that built the car had taken home.
Wow.
Now, to get it straight, you bought the car before you did all this.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's a good hunch.
You convinced your dad, you convinced your grandmother, you convinced the whole family that they were going to spend all this money on an old car, and then you'd prove it to be the real thing.
Yeah. Well,
you're a man with nerve.
So speaking of Camaros and firsts, this is actually the second Z28 off the line in 1967, but the first Camaro to net GM a win in the Trans Am circuit. So we're here with the owner, Pat. Fire it up.
Pat, thank you for that.
Yeah, this won two races in 67 with Mark driving it, and it won Sebring in 68. They rolled the Trans Am into the 12-hour race, so it was a 12-hour Trans Am, which Mark won, and it finished third overall in the 12-hour.
The car has been vintage raced every year since 1987, and Jim and I learned pretty fast that Pat doesn't mind getting a few scratches on the paint either.
It's just a Camaro, and you can't crash the history out of a car.
that's a good one.
Yeah, definitely.
You can't crash the history out of a car. I like that.